Good morning, Knights, and welcome back to the Westmount Highlights. It's the week of May 10th, 2021. On behalf of everyone who was able to participate in last week's presentations and breakout sessions, I want to give a big thanks to Sweethearts and Heroes for dropping by our Sec 1 and 2 classes last week. I know that your message of hope and perseverance really reverberated, so thank you. And some fun news, we will be having a dress down day on Friday, May 14th. Students who are online on Friday will have their own dress down day on Thursday, May 13th. Students who make a donation of $2 may replace their uniform with acceptable clothing for school, and proceeds will go towards the Myra's Kids Foundation, which is an organization that provides monthly bereavement support groups for children and their extended families, a very worthy cause. This week, the TWH crew is back with more classic segments and reviews. Then we'll get to a special edition of Birthday Shoutouts on the other end. But first, we have a special guest interview with a former Knight, a student who came to WHS in 2009, and now will be attending, wait for it, the Masters in Architecture program at Harvard University. From WHS to Harvard. Here's me and Miss Karen speaking with Juan Fernandez Gonzalez.
Hi everyone, my name is Juan Fernandez Gonzalez. I'm from Mexico, and in 2009, when I was 12 years old, I moved to Canada, and I attended Westmount High School for grades 7 and 8 in those same years. And then I had to change schools and many things happened. And I recently found out that I was admitted to Harvard. So I was super excited, and also like, thanks to financial aid, it's going to be possible. And that's where I'm gonna continue my Master in Architecture Studies in August. So yeah, and I'm very happy to say that Westmount High School was part of the journey at the very beginning. Yeah.
So you got accepted into Harvard.
Yeah, exactly.
Wow. Can you tell us?
Yeah. Well, maybe I can go back to like Westmount High School quickly. I grew up in Mexico, and then I moved to Canada at age 12, and I had a basic level of English, and like enough to communicate, but. Starting school was still something difficult for me. And then I started at Westmount High School, and I just felt so welcomed by all the staff, all my friends, and it was an amazing experience.
And what
and I feel like my time, oh, that was 2009. So it was, I did first grade 7 and 8.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, so there, I had to go to a French school, but then my path changed. And I ended up at McGill, and then the two profs, when I graduated, told me that I should try applying to Harvard, and I found that crazy, and so I did it, and like a couple of months ago, I found out that I was accepted with like also a good amount of financial aid. Wow. So that's what's gonna make it possible, and I'm really excited to start.
What was it about your time at Westmount that was so, I guess, memorable?
I guess so many things were happening in my life. It's like just changing countries, speaking a new language, meeting people, not only from Canada, but from all over the world. I remember in my homeroom, maybe out of 30 people, there were like almost 20 from other places, either that they moved here as kids or like more recently like me. Mm-hmm. And that's something I had never seen before. So mm-hmm. I feel like that, and also the diversity of the teachers and all the staff, that made me like much more open-minded. And that's something that has helped me like just like throughout my life, I guess. And I always think back to that moment when I began like in homeroom 108 with Miss Ahmed and my classmates. So yeah, that was awesome. And also I guess I love getting involved. And if some current students watch this, I recommend you to get involved in all sorts of things like sports teams, this student council with SAGIP, like I was also part of that.
Mm.
And I think it was all really inspiring and just kind of like motivated me, not only at Westmount, but also in my studies after. You might forget some things that you learned when you were young,
mm-hmm.
others you'll remember, but I feel like something that always stays with you is the desire to learn. And just like the desire to learn that I had at Westmount High School, it helped me like through, like until now.
You carried that forward.
So I mentioned my math teachers because math and particularly geometry is something that I've always loved. And I always like trying to like explore new things. Like I remember in the classroom, I would always ask like the weird questions. like particularly for math. And then when I was in Sejip, I went to Brebeuf, and I happened to, like, I was drawing and I discovered a geometric construction that happened to be new.
Wow.
Yeah. And then, like, I kept working on it, like, a lot. It was, like, a process, like, over a year. And eventually, like, a university professor that was, like, my prof's former teacher, former professor, and this geometry discovery got published as I was finishing Sejip. And I think that that really helped me to also get into the architecture program. And because it can relate to architecture too, like, it's about space. And then also continuing this, like, math passion, I also discovered something in university and then it got published. And I'm hoping to continue to work on more papers.
That's amazing. I didn't even know you could make a geometric discovery anymore. Settled.
Well, it's great one, because you shared with us already some of the things that kind of made why Westmount was special to you and why you always make sure to reconnect. Like, you connect with us and you keep in touch with Mr. Gail, Ms. Ahmed, and we feel part of your journey and we feel part of your travels. And I'm glad that we were part of that journey, and I can't wait to hear about the way this journey progresses. It just keeps getting more and more interesting, and we're really proud of you and all of the things that you're doing.
Oh, thank you so much, Karen. And it's always really nice to reach out to, like, my teachers and the school, because I do think that it was a really important part of my journey, and I really enjoyed my time there. So I'm happy to talk to you again.
I know the like, as an educator myself, and I'm sure Karen feels the same way, there's no better feeling than hearing from your former students and seeing where they are now and how their time, you know, with you or in a school or what have you, how that shaped them, how that influenced them. I think it's so inspiring. So I, on behalf of your teachers and Ms. Ahmed and everyone, just, you know, I want to say thank you for coming back and saying hi and letting us know where you are. And for any future graduates, you know, we expect that of you. We want you to come back and see where you're, you know, we want to hear about all your accomplishments and everything. Thank you so much, Juan. Very, very
welcome. Cool.
And like Karen said, we're proud of you. I'm only just meeting you, but it's really an amazing accomplishment. And thanks for reaching out and coming back and sharing your story with us.
Okay, thank you, Matthew and Karen. You too.
Bye. Take care.
Bye.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Hey, Brendan.
So what's new with you guys?
There's a gremlin outside.
What are you talking about?
Out on the window. There's a gremlin. An evil gremlin. they can't see it, but for some reason, I seem to be the only one who could see it. Why? Why?
Ben, calm down. Look at me. Look at my eyes. There's no gremlin outside. There is no gremlin.
Are you sure?
Yes. Rickav, what are you eating?
I am eating a mush-hush biscuit sandwich. It is a biscuit layered with peanut butter with a mushroom in the middle and to look like a sandwich.
Okay, well, that's disgusting.
It is not disgusting, Brendan. It is only disgusting for you weird folk.
These things came from space. These things, they came from space. They said they want to serve man, but turns out that's not the type of serve. They wanna eat us!
Okay, Ben, once again, calm down. There's no aliens trying to eat us.
Are you sure about that?
Aliens, calm down. Ragav, what are you doing?
Well, what does it look like? I'm mixing up a banana and with the peel on with Nutella.
But the peel!
That has all the best nutrients. You weird folk don't understand that.
There's one more thing. There's this woman, all bandaged up. People say that she has to be bandaged up because she is so hideous, but in actuality, she's actually really beautiful. It's actually everyone else who is all ugly. Because they're so ugly, they think she's ugly. Why? Are we really that ugly? Why?
Okay, Somebody explain to me what's going on.
Well, it's actually eat what you want to eat day on May 11th, which is why I'm trying out all these weird combinations of food.
And also on May 11th is Twilight Zone Day. You know, the anthology series. Anyone?
Okay, well, that explains it. That helps a lot.
Yeah, so I did too. Help me with it. I can binge watch the entire series, and well, I haven't been taking that really well. Want me to tell you one more thing about it?
No!
Hey guys, it's me, Matt. And for this movie review, I will be reviewing the film The Cat Returns. The Cat Returns is a Studio Ghibli anime film about this schoolgirl named Haru who one day saves a cat from getting hit by a truck. But it turns out that cat is actually a prince from a magical cat kingdom. And the king of the cat kingdom wants to thank Haru by having her marry the prince. Naturally, Haru doesn't want to, but the cats take her away anyway. So she enlisted the help of a magical cat figurine named Baron, and together they must escape the cat kingdom. This film is good. You should definitely watch it. The characters are fun to watch, the animation is impressive in some scenes, and this film, to me, is the most funniest film ever made by Studio Ghibli, because there are so many gags in there that can make you chuckle. If you're into anime, or if you're a cat person, or you just, want to watch something that can make you laugh a little bit, then I suggest The Cat Returns. Thank you for listening.
You know what that sound means? It's time to give out some birthday love. So happy birthday to the following students: Nicole Simon, Angelica Moore, Anastasia Torres Hernandez, Bubakar Toure, Phoenix Coombs, Keisha Da Silva Pillai, Mahadi Hassan Khan, Christina Cronin, Michael Dehaney, Jinyu Bao, Dehang Wang, Isabel Aguirre, Francesca Amaru, Sarah Brin, Madeline Amy Jabala, Emma Farrow, Ruyang Huang, Ayan Nafis, and Luca Pizzi. Happy birthday to all of you. I hope you guys have a great week. We'll be back next Monday with another episode. Until then, we'll keep the nightlights on. Be well.